Hello. When using a TI device, it's important to utilize the TI datasheet that can be found on the product pages on TI.com. For more troubleshooting information, refer to TI.com/troubleshooting. Detecting oscillations for a linear operational amplifier can be difficult. In today's training, we will go through three different methods on detecting oscillations. Before we begin, it's important to note that TI has additional training collateral online. This includes TI Precision Labs regarding a course on stability, TI's Analog Engineer's Pocket Reference, and the Board Level Troubleshooting Series. In addition, TI also has free simulation software called Tina TI that can be downloaded for free at ti.com/tina-ti. For today's demonstration, we will be using the OPA-846, a high-speed decompensated operational amplifier. Using this device, we will be showing three different techniques to measure the oscillations. The first will be to measure the supply current or quiescent current. The second method will be to monitor the output waveform. And the third method will be to use an antenna to measure these oscillations. The OPA-846 has been configured to a low gain and unstable state. Note that the datasheet defines that the device is stable only for gains greater than 7. This specific configuration is used to emulate a customer board application in order to show how to measure the oscillations. Now let's move on to the demonstration. We will be using the power supply set to a plus or minus 5 volts to power the board. And connected is the multimeter, which will monitor the supply current. We will also be using the LaCroix 1 GHz oscilloscope to monitor the output. And this is the board that we will be using in today's demonstration. Now we will turn on the power supply. Note that the supply current measured by the multimeter is about 19 milliamps. This is higher than the specified range for supply current in the datasheet. However, note that a high supply current is a symptom of oscillations, and an oscillating device might not always have a high supply current issue. Now moving on towards the waveform, I will freeze this waveform so that we can view it better. Because there is no input signal into the board, we would expect the output to be constant and stable. However, because the part is oscillating, we are observing an abnormal periodic waveform on the scope at this time. This is a sign that the part is oscillating. Note that the exact waveform can vary because the part is operating in the nonlinear region and behavior can be unpredictable. Now, if you're unable to access the output signal from your board, you can use an alternative method using a loop antenna. This loop antenna that we're using today is created by using an insulated wire wrapped into a coil and soldered onto an SMA connector, which is then connected to our oscilloscope. Now we will reconfigure the oscilloscope for this next part of the demo. Now when you press the coil against different areas of the board, you will start to notice that on your oscilloscope you will see different waveforms. As you get closer to the operational amplifier, these waveforms magnitudes will start to get larger. This is a sign that your part is oscillating. This is an alternative method that you can use to measure the oscillations on your op amp. I've shown you three different techniques that can be used to determine if your operational amplifier is oscillating. For further information, please go to ti.com/troubleshooting. Thank you for watching.